Everybody, we're just about set. How the hell are you doing? All right, so our battle, Ottawa, has a bit of a reputation. We may not be the largest city, but we're the loudest. So I'm gonna make you make a lot of noise tonight. You can do that, right, Ottawa? All right, amazing. So before I introduce your artist, I'll just go over the rules real quick. The artists only have 20 minutes to create an original piece in their signature style. All work will be up for auction. Starting bid is only $50. It's like a $20 canvas, so it's a pretty damn good deal. Something else we like to do is we call the slow tornado. So throughout the night, we're all gonna walk in a clockwise formation.
Direction
would be the word, yes, thank you. And no elbows, no knees, no hitting below the belt. Make it the world's friendliest mosh pit, if you will. And if you don't want to walk around in circles, please make your way out towards the back and let other people through. If you want to take pictures, please tag us, hashtag Art Battle Ottawa, hashtag live painting, yada, yada, yada. It's a great way to show your support for these amazing local artists. And you just about ready to start, Ottawa? All right. So tonight, also, we are being live streamed on the Art Battle Network. You can find us on YouTube, Art Battle Ottawa. So if you do see our live streamer or our photographer, please allow them to get through, give them priority, and it would be much appreciated. And I think we're set. Artists, are you ready?
Yes.
Jabber, leave her alone, she's gotta work. Scoot. Please, thank you. Much appreciated. All right. So, on easel number one, Kristen Shire. On easel number two, Panda. On easel number three, Nilu. And on easel number five, Vincent Bolduc. And last but certainly not least, on easel number six, Heather Caraccio. And I've totally forgot about easel number four, apparently. I don't know how I did that. Guess now we know why I didn't stay in school. Mitchell Antoine Renault, everyone. So if you haven't registered your phone number, which gives you the ability to vote and bid, please do so at the front. And also, let me introduce tonight's spotlight artist, Stephanie Victorine, last month's winner. She'll be painting throughout the evening for you as well, doing a long painting, and you'll find her under round number four, so you can bid on her work as well. So, I almost forgot all about that. Thank you for waving me down. I do this only once a month, and I keep getting rustier and rustier, it seems. All right? Oh, God. Old man. Next month, if you come back, it's on the 6th. It's my birthday. 52 years old, and still going. Come back and party with us then. It's going to be one hell of a show. But in the meantime, let's get this one going. So I'm going to get you to help me. And we'll go, and we're gonna go from 10, 9,
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Art Battle Ottawa. We have just begun round number one, and we have our first six incredible artists up at the easels right now. Here we are with Kristen Shire. And Kristen is really well known for doing these just absolutely stunning, super bold landscape works. And she often starts off with quite a warm palette. And here we are moving over to Heather Cargio. Heather is really well known for creating works that are quite whimsical. She's an artist that I always love seeing up at the Art Battle stage. And she just brings so much fun and humor to the easel. So really can't wait to see where Heather is going with her piece. It looks like right now she's got a series of circles going on. So I think that that is going to take shape into kind of one of her signature characters. Here we are with Vincent Bolduc. And I have known Vincent's work for quite a long time. He is an Art Battle Ottawa All-Star. He's painted over a vast number of seasons. So he is a seasoned veteran artist at Art Battle. And here he is giving us this gorgeous gradient with, I think he's using a sponge here to kind of diffuse all of these different colors. And we can also see that he has used tape on the canvas as well. So I think we're gonna get a really satisfying tape pull out of that that will reveal some crisp lines. And here we are with Michel-Antoine Renaud. And he has actually painted in Art Battle Quebec City before as well. So we've seen him there. And now he is here bringing his talent to the stage in Ottawa. Michel-Antoine is really, his work is quite textural and evolves over time. So really looking forward to seeing how that plays out within the constriction of the 20-minute time limit. Over with Nilou. And Nilou's work is often super, super bold, but always has some sort of an intense emotional component going on. And already I'm feeling like she's going to be going for a really dramatic work with this heavy use of black here. But we have a void in the center of the canvas that she's left blank and is now doing a really interesting technique to create a perfect circle. Super smart. And here we are with Panda. Oh, not quite. Still with Nilou. Working on this black, and I think that she's actually going to be getting it right up to that perfect circle that she created. So that shows some good planning there, that she'd laid down her background and then created that perfect circle as a guideline of where she wanted the background to butt up to. And here we are with Panda, aka Alex Barker, and Alex is also a tried and true Art Battle Ottawa All-Star and always brings some really, really crispy work to the easel. So looking forward to seeing this piece unfold. Right now looks like Panda is creating a profile portrait, which is one of the more difficult things to pull off in Art Battle, because a portrait, we really need to be quite aware of the proportions of the face. And when you turn it to its side, you don't have the ability to rely on symmetry. So anything that's off becomes really obvious. Back over with Kristen, and we can see that Kristen is using lots of warm colors to start off this piece. We've got some orange in the bottom corner there, and we can also see that she's used orange to kind of create the map of her tree and is now working over top of it in this bluish purple color. That's something that I always really enjoy about Kristen's work, is she really loves to play with hot and cold color palettes and use them at the same time and use cool colors on top of warm colors. And it just creates this really unique color vibration within her works that really help make things come alive. Back over with Heather. And her piece is now evolving some rainbow elements going on, taking up space around her central character. And now I'm beginning to wonder if this is a central character, the spear here, or if that is a component of a larger character that's coming into play in the background. So we will see what the area of focus ends up being here. But this is very cool so far.
See that he is leaning into creating a character right now. Vincent really likes to play with proportion and exaggeration within his character pieces. And we can see that here we've got, looks like some ears going on, this kind of pushed up nose. So I'm wondering maybe he might be doing some sort of animal, or if he's just got a character that has more animalistic features. Michelle and Antoine,
and this piece is coming together really, really nicely. We definitely have the major components of an animal being established with his signature super textural approach, and I'm also getting kind of a sense of maybe that there's something else going on in the interior of this animal also. I'm thinking either maybe he's gonna be capturing some sort of landscape within that creature, or if he's going to continue layering this fur over top. And still exploring what kind of animal this is. Right now I'm thinking we could be going with a wolf. Back with Nilu, and looks like that perfect circle that she was drawing is now showing itself to be a full moon. And we've just got this really stark use of contrast from Nilu here, who is adding in a little bit of that kind of shadowed textural component into showing those craters in the moon. And so we've got the highest points of contrast being background, the white of the moon, and then she's bringing in a little bit of mid-tone as well. Back with Panda, and we can see that there's just this really beautiful wistfulness that Alex is creating in his character here. This portrait is just stunning. We have this really soft expression. The chin is upraised a little bit, and we've got the portrait situated in the bottom corner, so it really gives the illusion that the character is in a larger space and is kind of has this sense of awe. Really, really enjoying that piece. Difficult to believe that that's only a 9-minute painting so far. Wild. Back with Kristen, and we can see that she's using even more of these warm colors, layering these kind of tufted leaves over top of the skeleton of branches that she's created for her tree. And she's got this beautiful golden color that she's now layering this super bold carmine red over top of, and that is playing very nicely with the purple that she'd used on the tree trunk. Back over with Heather, and something occurred to me as we were here last time, and I'm thinking, and we might have to wait until we get a little bit of a better view. I'm thinking that this might be like a super macro portrait of a frog, but maybe that's not right either. We're seeing lots of different kind of layers making their way into that rainbowscape there. And we are officially at the halfway mark in round number one of our battle in Ottawa tonight. So many of these works are just coming together in such a super gorgeous, bold way. This is definitely a high quality round, especially when we consider that this is only the halfway point. Back over with Vincent. And the color play in the background is really interesting here because we have a lot more neutrality that's being expressed in the face of the character. We're using a lot of gray tones and more somber colors. And so that creates a contrast and a juxtaposition against the warmer and more playful colors that he's using in the background. Back over with Michelle Antoine, and we can see that through the use of this orange, that I think that the animal is being revealed now as a fox. And we've got two hits of super, super bright yellowy green hanging out for the eyes there. And I love the thoughtfulness of the placement and the opacity and the color story there. Michelle Antoine is definitely an artist who loves to play with vibrancy. Moving back over to Nilu here, and we can see that she is continuing to work into those mid-tones and really establish the peaks and valleys of the craters in the moon here. She's spending a lot of time rendering all of those shadows and really giving us the impression of a 3D object in space. Back over with Panda, and he's now adding in more elements into that negative space that we had. He'd already established this really beautiful softness of clouds in a sky, and now we can see that he's using stark black to kind of disrupt that. And so I'm thinking maybe we've got a tree, or potentially this is meant to be metaphorical and looking like a broken glass or something like that. One thing that I really love about this portrait also is the use of purple in those shadows on the face. It's just such a soft color palette that he's using here and is using it really well. Wow, big moves from Kristen here. We have the background already put in, and I was wondering how she was going to do that. I was thinking that this might be a little bit of a complicated piece to get some background color in, but she's done an expert job of taking this color up really tightly to all of those different pieces of foliage and also allowing for a small amount of overlap where the color is bleeding into the background color. And this gives us this kind of gorgeous painterly quality where we have just little tiny subtle blends happening. Back with Heather, and I was correct in my first assumption. The central circle is definitely its own character, and it now has eyes and a mouth and is just this hilarious little being. I think he might even be a donut. I think that we're getting little sprinkles making their way onto some icing here. And this is just so funny and so cute and also really well executed. Heather's work is always just super joyful at the easel. And I think that she brings this really wonderful, lighthearted sense of humor to the competition. Back with Vincent here, And we're getting some cooler colors being introduced into the background as well, kind of harmonizing a little bit with some of the tones that have been established in the face. He's bringing this kind of purpley tone into the background that has been used in the face for the shadows. And also you can see that it's quite present in the eye as well. We've got just 5 minutes remaining in round number one of Art Battle in Ottawa, and voting is now open. Head over to artbattle.com/AB2653 and cast your vote for your favorite artist. The top two artists from this round, as voted by the audience, will be moving forward into a third and final round. So be sure to choose your favorite artist, and when you're voting, think not only about the quality of the work that you're seeing here and what you liked the most visually, but also whose performance you enjoyed the most. Because if you vote for one of those top two artists, you may get a chance to see them painting again in the final. So be sure to go to the link at the bottom of your screen, artbattle.com/AB2653, and make sure that you get registered to vote. Also, all of the works created tonight are available for silent auction. So please be sure to support these artists by collecting their work as well. Bidding starts quite low, so it's a great way to start that art collection. Back with Nilou, and we've really gone a long way in establishing the 3D quality of this moon here. Just really, really gorgeous. I love the super stark use of contrast that she's got going on here. And in our, as we round into the final 3 minutes, I have to say that this piece is really beautifully rendered.
We're just coming up to that 3 minute mark. How you doing, Ottawa? Oh, come on, you can do better than that.
And we now have the reveal of what those lines were for from Panda. Looks like we have some beautiful cherry blossoms that are just making their appearance into frame. Really softly executed. Usually I'd be a little bit upset with that high contrast element being introduced to such a soft painting, but I think that Panda has done it really well here with just like the suggestion of those sakura blossoms. Over with Kristen here, and this piece has just come together so beautifully and feels so celebratory of autumn. Autumn in Ottawa is just such a beautiful experience, so I'm sure that the audience is really appreciating and connecting to this piece based on that. And now we can see that she's going back in and just adding in just a few small connective elements that had been obscured by her putting in those background colors. Just tightening it up, giving us some point of shadow also, showing that there is shadow on the branches underneath those collections of leaves. More and more fun and joyfulness from Heather. Not only has our donut character very much come to life with a face, he now has gained a hat, is slipping on ice cream, and we've also got some trees that have been added into the background as well. Definitely some higher elements of contrast being added by Vincent here. We've got this dark black that has been surrounding the face and really helps to push that face forward. So much sumptuous texture coming in from Michel Antoine. and getting our last minute detail from Nilu with the sparkling spattering of stars with a toothbrush. Really, really smart execution here, and I really like that they're quite subtle as well.
Round number one, you should be receiving a message any moment now saying that it is time to vote and it is time to bid. To get those votes in quickly, and we'll be right back for round number two. Thank you.
Just keep meeting you.
Absolute stunner of an opening round for our battle in Ottawa tonight. And now comes the hard part. It is your time to vote. So head over to artbattle.com/AB2653 and cast your vote for your favorite artist. These guys have worked super hard in the last 20 minutes to create these wonderful pieces right in front of your eyes. Many of them have practiced at home and are bringing skill that they have honed over years and years to the easel for us here tonight. So be sure to support them with your votes and also participate in the auction. We will be back for round number two of our next six artists in the competition in just a few minutes.
Thank you. Isma, Miss Stephanie. Just moved here from Alberta a couple years ago, finding her feet in the artist community.
Ladies and gentlemen, so tonight's artists were pre-selected, 11 of them. We have one other spot for what we love to call the wild card artist. These brave souls have put their name in the hat, if you will. And let's see who it's going to be. Actually, this looks sketchy. I could be cheating. I'll let our DJ Aquarock. Torok, sorry. It is Monica. Woo! Where are you, Monica? Monica Pereira, is that right? Monica, amazing. You'll go see, go into the paint room and our paint captains will help you get everything you need. Thank you.
Thank you.
easels, please. All artists to their easels. Just about ready to go. Make sure all artists are at their easels. We're missing somebody on easel number two. All right, here she comes. So let me introduce your artist for round number two. On easel number one, Melanie McDonald. On easel number two, as a last minute substitution, an incredible artist and a dear friend, Angela McGowan. On easel number three, John Normando. On easel number four, Jennifer Ford. On easel number five, Kina Forney. And last, but certainly not least, tonight's wild card artist, Monica Pereira! All right. Are you ready, Ottawa? You want to get this one going? All right, so with your help from 10, 9, tornado going once again. Please remember to be kind, and we'll all have a good time.
Welcome back, everyone, to round number two of Art Battle in Ottawa tonight. Here we are at the easel of Melanie McDonald, and I believe that this is actually Melanie's very first time painting in Art Battle, so welcome to Melanie. Melanie describes herself as someone who does a lot of cosplaying, so I think that we're going to see some really cool details making their way into her work. Here we are at easel number two with Angela McGowan. Angela is an absolute Art Battle all-star. I've seen her paint quite a few times, although not in a little while, and I'm a huge, huge Angela fan, so I really cannot wait to see what she brings to the easel tonight. I always find that Angela just has this wonderful ability to create narratives that just really draw you in with her signature characters. And right now we've got quite a lot of action going on with this red and blue, and she's doing a lot of blending on the canvas at the same time. Got a little piece of shop towel or rag there, I think, and she's actually using that to meld these colors together into this neutral tone. I gotta say, mad talent. She's so intuitive with the way that she paints. Here we are with John Normando, and John has told us that he is quite new to painting. He began painting in 2023 this summer, and so really exciting to see his trajectory making its way to the Art Battle stage. And we've got some crazy techniques happening from John here. We've got looks like a shower squeegee that he's using. and lots and lots of paint on the canvas. This emerald tone, we've got a couple of little hits of yellow and red as well. I think that we can expect a really bold performance from John. Getting very textural already, going in there with a palette knife.
Moving over to Jennifer Ford.
We've seen Jennifer paint quite a few times in Art Battle, and she always creates these really moving, wonderful, immersive pieces. I think that we've seen her do quite a lot of floral work, so this looks like it is off of the beaten path of her usual Art Battle creations. And we can see that she's got a little bit of a landscape going on with a super bold red sky. Getting into the addition of some yellow with that red, so I think we're going to get a really beautiful sunset gradient. And here we are with Kina Forney. Kina is an incredible artist, very well known in the Art Battle Ottawa scene. We've seen her paint quite a few times, almost I think since the beginning of Art Battle Ottawa in 2013. And she always absolutely brings it to the easel. We most recently saw her painting at the 2023 Ottawa City Championship, where she created some really stunning character-based work. Here we are with Kina working in this teal color, and I think that she's just established a horizon line there, so we'll have to see how that develops. And then last but certainly not least, our brave wildcard artist, Monica Pereira. For those that don't know, a wildcard artist is someone who takes the final spot at the easel. We like to book 11 artists in advance and leave one easel open to be claimed by someone in the room at the event. It just adds a little bit of spice and helps us to meet lots of new artists, and is a really crazy experience for the people that get pulled for it because they have no prep time. They just have to step up to the easel, and it definitely takes a brave soul to do it. So thank you so much, Monica. Making our way over again to Melanie, and this piece is sick already. I'm loving this jackalope character that she's creating. I love the color choice, super unconventional with that pinkish red color. I think that's probably a rubine red. Just really, really lovely. And then we can see that she's going in with a warmer red over top, a little bit of an orangey color. And I just know that I'm going to love the way that the color story of this piece plays out. Just by looking at her palette, it looks like we have lots of different colors represented, and I'm sure that she's going to be putting all of them to really good use. And the rapid brushwork that she's doing here is definitely helping to establish that kind of little textural detail of fur for this character here. Melanie describes herself as someone who does cosplay and is really interested in character work, so I can definitely see that kind of fantasy element coming into play here for this jackalope painting. Back over with Angela McGowan, and I love the way that this piece is coming together. She's really intentionally muddying colors in such a cool way, and you don't see that often. Usually we're like, oh, stay away from overblending, stay away from mixing opposite colors together. But we can see that there is such an absolute intentionality here from Angela, and she is so familiar with her craft and really knows what she's doing. And I think that this is just a big part of her performance aspect of creating at Art Battle.
hitting us with the unexpected, and now we can see that she's going in with more of a pure tone of the cerulean blue. It looks like she's establishing some shadow portions of the face, helping to establish the planes of the face, the shape of the features. John here, and looks like John is going in a floral direction. We've got a couple of swipes of this red here that are looking like they're coming out from one central point that he's used this brown color. So I think that we're going to be having a really wonderful field of flowers. And already we can see that he's using distance and the creation of perspective here, because we've got just little hits of red in the top. And it looks like it's a receding flower field, and then they get bigger as they come closer and lower onto the canvas, closer to the viewer. So really advanced techniques here in creating perspective and really concentrating on working to create an immersive environment from John. So definitely impressed here. See that Jennifer is really working to give us this hot and cold color story, and just really doing some really bold work here. We've got this yellow that is merging into the red of the sky, and we can see that she's kind of used the movement of the brush strokes to suggest wind on these clouds, the suggestion of clouds that she's creating. We also have a really intense concentrated use of ultramarine blue for the water at this point. And here we are with Kina, and this is just so much fun. I had originally thought, because we had that midpoint horizontal line that we last saw her making, I totally thought that this was going to be some sort of landscape, but it's definitely looking like we've got some sort of gaming console that she's creating, and then she is painting a smaller piece within the screen of the gaming console. So never one to disappoint. Kina always really enjoys working innovative ideas into her art battle pieces. And here we are at the halfway point, the official halfway point for Art Battle, round number 2 of Art Battle in Ottawa. And voting is now open, so head over to artbattle.com/AB2653 to get registered to vote. You don't have to be ready quite yet to vote, but be sure to get registered there. You can also check out the auction at that link as well. Back with Monica here, our wildcard artist. And looks like she is creating a jellyfish. We've got lots of wonderful movement coming from the tendrils of the jellyfish that she's created. Nice central composition, and we have this kind of focused light source that diffuses outward. So we've got darker edges and then this concentration of light on the center to feature the jellyfish and really drive home that focus. Getting some circles added in here. I think that those are going to be bubbles. I like that she's kind of breaking up the composition by having some of the bubbles going off of the canvas as well. Back over with Melanie and our jackalope here. We have some interesting compositional elements that have been added as well. The green line, the green circle that is disrupted by these black strikes is really interesting and definitely adds a lot for me. I was thinking that the composition was going to be quite difficult because there was a lot of negative space, and through just those additions of those subtle lines, we've done a lot to break up that negative space in the background and really hone in on the design element of this piece.
really, really digging this piece. Also, the use of that green is picking up on the green that she's used for the pupil of the eye of her character, too. So nice little addition there. Back over with Angela. And I love that there's just so much activity in this piece. We still have drips that are really actively dripping and changing the painting. And Angela now is concentrating into the face and using more pure colors here, but also picking up wet paint and blending on the canvas. Still, we've got the use of the cerulean blue. We've got a darker, more ultramarine or Prussian blue that we've got for the darkest shadows. And then we can see that she's using that neutral purpley gray that she created right in the beginning to act as the high points, the highlights of the face, catching where the light is. And now we're getting this lovely use of shape of shadow underneath the chin. Back with John here and his field of flowers. And we definitely have some main character status going on from our central floral here and our kind of trio in the foreground. Lots and lots of texture going on, really jumping out at us. And we can see that he's using his knife to mix his work as he goes. Not completely fully mixing the color to be totally uniform. There's still some points of color that are unmixed that make it onto the knife that add in little stripes of variation within the strokes that he's applying, which is nice. Back over with Jennifer, and I love the addition of these trees on the rock. It just really adds a dynamic quality of movement for this piece. We can really see them just reaching into the frame, loving that detail there. And I think as we catch it on camera here that those trees have been done in the same blue that is present in the water as well. And more detail being added in from Jennifer. We can see that she's creating a reflective quality on the water where the waves are picking up the color of the sky. Just beautiful. Into our last 5 minutes here, and still with Kina and her super careful execution of this Game Boy console here. I'm wondering whether or not Kina is gonna give us a big point of interest within the screen of the Game Boy. I would love to see that, but we are definitely ticking down in time. Kina is quite a seasoned artist for Art Battle though, so I'm sure that she's gonna bring out some surprise for us. To our wild card artist, who is now adding in more major tendrils onto this jellyfish and really using some kind of vibrating brush movement to add like frills into the brushwork too, which is very cool. Definitely adding some great movement here. Getting into the shine of the bubbles here as our final moments tick down and these artists really hone in on those final details. colony here, and we can see that quite a lot has been done in this piece, and we've really expanded into the composition with these fluffy brush marks here, adding points of interest within the background. I like the technique that Melanie is applying here with the use of the fan brush, just adding in little highlighting moments on the ruff of fur that she's got going on. And into our final 2 minutes of the round of Art Battle in Ottawa. And we can see that Angela has just continued to add points of interest into this portrait. We've got this detail that she's now really emphasized, this yellow circle around the portrait, definitely evoking some religious iconography tones, which is a common theme within Angela's work, and really just a wonderful execution here. And we've got our hits in the center of these florals here. A little bit of yellow to just kind of create that point of focus as the petals converge into the center of the flower. Jennifer adding in some final highlights onto the trunks of her trees. Really driving home that the final rays of sunlight in the day are just cascading over this landscape, picking up on the trunks of the trees, and just really wonderful detail here.
Rushes down. There you go, Andrew. All right, so as you vote, the top two for rounds one and two will move on to the third and final round for Battle of Four. So get those votes in quickly, and we'll be right back.
A really fantastic set of six paintings for our second round of Art Battle in Ottawa tonight. Just such a variety of styles and executions, and everybody really decided to play a lot with color this round as well. Some very, very exciting work. And now comes the hard part. Now is your time to vote. So head over to artbattle.com/AB2653 and cast your vote for your favorite artist. The top two artists, as voted by the audience, will be moving forward into a third and final round. They will be facing our top two artists from first round, top two artists from this round, and everybody will paint again with another 20 minutes on the clock and another blank canvas to tackle. So make sure that you get in there, head to that link, and also all of the works created tonight are available for silent auction. So if you want to support these artists and grow your art collection or perhaps start one, make sure that you bid in the auction as well and support these artists in that way, because it's a great way to start a collection and a great way to capture the memory of watching these pieces being created. All right, we will be back with our finalist announcement in just a few minutes to figure out who our top four are going to be.
close the race for one and two for Brown, number two. To get those votes in, every vote counts. Thank you.
Peter Purdy!
Certainly not least, moving on, tonight's last minute sub, Angela McGowan! Amazing. Okay, we're gonna get these artists set up and we'll be right back for the third and final round. You have time to grab another drink and we'll be right back. me, Estelle.